Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and today I'm here to talk to you about applying HTV to a hat without a heat press. Now, I say that, I do mean without a heat press, but also without a hat press, all right? Now, I won't lie, if you want nice, pretty, full designs, okay, this is gonna be a little bit more difficult than using a hat press. All right, if you do a lot of hats, or especially if you are wanting to sell hats, that hat press is gonna be an investment for you, okay? But if you're not, if you're like me, maybe you only press one or two hats a year, really not a big hat person, but sometimes I just need a good hat, right? So that is who I'm talking to today, and hopefully you guys are here to join me. And you know, let's grab a hat, grab some HTV, and we'll go ahead and get started.
All right, guys, so I am going to put a sunflower on my hat. My hat is a mustard yellow color, and I just think it's going to go really, really good. Now, I want to keep in mind that, number one, I plan on using flocked heat transfer vinyl. And what that means is kind of like if you've ever cut glitter heat transfer vinyl, it doesn't handle detail as well as some of the smooth heat transfer vinyls do. Okay, and that's all right. That doesn't make a big difference. It just means that when we're looking for a sunflower, we want to look for one with a thick outline. And I really like this one, and I think the outline is going to be thick enough for us. So I'm going to go ahead and add to cart and complete the checkout process. Now, I have been looking at other designs. I really like this one too. But let's see, let's go to checkout now. I'm going to save that one for later. I like doing that, and I end up with this whole little arsenal full of designs that I want to come back and use for a project. So continue to payment. Now, you know, I always like to use my store credit. It's just a thing that I do. All right, then I'm going to download it. Now, don't forget, now I'm in Windows, but this is true even for Mac. When they download in that zipped folder, you're going to have to unzip them. All right, so that's fine. I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then we will reconvene in our software and get started. So I'm in Silhouette Studio, so I'm going to file and merge. I already have a blank canvas here. So let's see, I need to go to my downloads, and I have already unzipped, there it is, my sunflower. And let's right click, view large icons. I can pick out the one that I want to use. I really just need the outline, and I don't need the center filled, so I'm going to choose, what's the difference? Here we go, this is the SVG format. Whoa, that came in a little big. That's okay, that's all right. We're not here to judge. Now, I've already measured my hat, and my hat tells me that I want this to be no bigger than 3 inches wide. So let's take a look at that. So I have my aspect ratio locked. I'm just gonna type in 3 inches here. All right, so that's pretty good for me. But one more thing is that I'm actually gonna split this design. Okay, now you guys don't have to. All right, I'm just gonna throw that out there. But I'm gonna split this design. So I'm gonna use my knife tool, and you will see exactly what I mean. When it's time to cut, this is an SVG file, so let's see what it does. All right, so the cut lines came on. Now remember, if you ever import an SVG file and you do not get the bold red lines, you just have to come over here and turn your cut lines on, okay? So just remember that. Now we are gonna switch this. I am cutting that flocked heat transfer vinyl. So we're going to go down to, heat transfer vinyl flocked. All right, I do personally use my ratchet blade, but I am also going to use Bluetooth. So I'm gonna run over to my Cameo and get my HTV loaded, and then we'll cut it and I'll show you guys how to weed it, okay? All right, now one important thing that we forgot to cover, because I was using a hat and the sunflower doesn't necessarily have to be mirrored, but don't forget, anytime you are cutting heat transfer vinyl, you do need the design mirrored. I prefer to do it on the cutting mat before going over to the send panel, but just in case, the software does remind you if you want to send it mirrored or not.
Okay, so here is my flocked HTV. You can see I feel like I got a pretty good cut. If in doubt, you can go ahead and do like a little test weed. There we go. Now remember, we might lose some of these details just because this is flocked. It's not really meant for high detail situations, but nonetheless, any details that we manage to keep will be really, really cute. And any that we lose, well, that'll be our little secret. So I'm gonna peel this off the mat. And just to make it easier, I am gonna go ahead and trim around. Now you just weed it out like normal. I do like to start with the outside, so I'm just gonna pierce underneath the corner, roll it back towards me. And I did get a really good cut, which I do love. It's always time to celebrate when we get a good cut. All right, so I'm gonna tear this. I'm not ready for the inside yet. Okay, so that's my sunflower. And remember when I sliced it in the middle, so I am gonna go ahead and cut these two apart. All right, now it's time for my hat. Let me show you the hat I'm working with. There we go. It's a nice mustard yellow. I think this is gonna go really good. So here's what I was talking about when I said I was gonna split it. I'm going to put part on the bill and part on the hat. All right, so hopefully you can see that, okay? And the reason I'm doing that is just to make it super cute. Also, it let me do a little bit bigger of a design. Another option I considered was doing a quarter of a sunflower, and that would have been really cute too. But where I'm going with that is I really try not to have to work with this seam right down the middle. To be honest with you, it's just kind of a pain in the rear. That's also why I choose to use flocked HTV, because it just seems to do better. Flocked and glitter and those thicker type of heat transfer vinyl instead of just the regular smooth. So let's go ahead and talk about what we need to do. We need to disassemble the hat. Not like in a complicated way, just in a, if it has anything inside, because this would melt under the heat anyway. We don't want that. Now, this is a pretty stiff hat, okay? And what I'm going to do, now let me say this, in the past, and it worked okay, I took a towel and just put as much of that towel inside that I can. This time, I'm gonna do a little bit different. I'm gonna put my mat inside, underneath, and then squish it down this way. And I think that'll get me a little bit better pressure. Now I am using my Cricut Mini. And let me just say that it's not that I can't do this with a household iron. I can. I can totally do this with a household iron. But I would have a hard time doing it with a full-size heat press or even a full-size easy press. So don't be too alarmed if you don't get as good results trying to use one or either of those. Also, the flocked isn't super tacky, so I'm gonna have to hold it a little bit, but that's okay. All right, so it's in place, and my trusty Teflon sheet. All I wanna do is cover it with a corner. I don't wanna go crazy with it. I wanna make sure I'm getting it all and get the main part of it first. Go ahead and apply some pressure to that and then come back and pay more attention to around the seam there. Okay, and you may have to stop, rearrange your hat a little bit, that's okay. Don't worry about flattening out unless you have some sort of super delicate hat, then you don't have to worry about that. Now, I'm having a hard time getting right here, so I'm actually going to pick it up and hold it like this. I'm still gonna cover it with the Teflon, but that's why I wanted this pressing pillow underneath. If you don't have anything like that, you can also use like an oven mitt or just something that's gonna help protect you from the heat. A thick towel would work. And so I'm pushing from the bottom and the top to try to get that good pressure that I need for heat transfer vinyl. Now pressure, I'm not gonna say it's not important for a hat. It's important anytime you're using heat transfer vinyl, but it's not as life or death as it is with t-shirts, because you're not going to wash this, typically speaking, you're not gonna wash it over and over. Okay, let's see what we got. Oh, I think this is a cold peel. Let's not play with this yet.
I'm going to press that corner back down. All right, let's let that cool off for just a minute. You see, I do have a few pressing marks here. That's okay because we can go and smooth those out once we're done. How are we working? All right, I think we might be okay. Woohoo! All right. Now, also remember, this is the perfect spot for a monogram. Now, I don't personally do monograms, but it'd be really, really cute to add a monogram there. So actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to trim a little bit of my design. Normally, I don't recommend freehand trimming, so you can use your best judgment. But I just cut a little bit. Can you see now it has that little dip? So that's going to allow me to line this up better. I can even cut out some more of the center. That's why I didn't want a sunflower that was full in the center. Okay. All right, much better. Can you see the difference? All right, so I'm going to grab my trusty Teflon sheet yet again. Let's see. Make sure it stays lined up. And this is actually a little bit easier because the brim of the hat is even easier than the front part of the hat. Just make sure you get right up against where the edge of that heat transfer vinyl is going to be. But be careful not to bump into any other exposed areas that aren't covered with the Teflon. We do not want to play that game. So we're going to let that cool. We already learned. It's a cold peel. Okay, there we go. So, really cute. I really like it a lot. It just adds a little bit of flair. Now, like I said, you can come across the seam. Just make sure that you're using a thicker type of heat transfer vinyl. And if you want to take out these pressing marks, grab your oven mitt or whatever else you have available and just treat it like an iron. Okay, see? Just like new. So we have the back of the hat. These are those cute crisscross hats and the front and our little sunflower.
Okay guys, so how did we do? What do you think? Is this a cute little accessory or what? Now, like I said, hats aren't really my thing. You know, fluff up my hair a little bit. They give me hat hair. Can't be having that. But really, really cute. And if I was out, you know, on a hot fall day, because, you know, in Florida, it's still hot during the fall, but this would be really super cute. It's a nice mustard yellow. I got my little sunflower and it was super easy. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I really appreciate you watching today. If you have any questions or comments, make sure you leave them below. I do come back and check in with you guys. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to the channel because we always have awesome tutorials planned for you right around the corner. Thanks again, guys. We'll see you next time.